Here's where the magic happens.
Old enough to fight the law.
Very magical.
Got a man twice her speed. Too much water on the bad sea.
I like those sounds.
Okay.
Here's the second studio, Super Day.
Pawned some new things and quite as a mouse. Broke her out of her parents' house.
That's Ray and Darius. There you go, that's Robert Earl Keen. Mariano. Really depends if you know what you're talking about. I'm Kenny of Kenny in the Afternoon. It's 6, or rather 4:06 right now. This time change is throwing me off big time. Scott, how about you?
I would suppose that it's been throwing me off all day.
Yeah.
But it's been in a good way.
Well, you're saying you're right. You have school going on, so you're busy.
I'm in a couple of classes at Oklahoma State in graduate school. Happen to be on Mondays, but yes, I spend a lot of time either on the road or having to go back to Stillwater and do some of my obligations for my coursework.
But well, you definitely seem like a animal lover because I was looking, just skimming over your bios and that sort of stuff. You've agriculture, livestock. You've been putting in that for a while. And veterinary tech work. Is that right?
I did some veterinary tech work whenever I was trying to get my prerequisites filled to go to vet school. I actually went to vet school at Texas A&M for 2 years, and then deferred. That wasn't really what I was looking for, but I wanted to make sure.
It said neurology.
Neurology.
For yeah, okay, and like in psychology for animals. Is there actually something for that?
Oh, right. I don't think there's much of a psychology.
That was talking about that.
Maybe it's in physiology.
It may have. I don't have glasses, and nor did I graduate high school. I did, but barely. I cheated on that. That's not God knows true. But okay, so I was reading into this. Okay, you're originally from Denison or Pales?
I was born in Denison, okay. Texas, the only hospital around there. But I went to high school in Pales.
Okay.
I went to grade school and high school in
Pales. And then you made your way north to Oklahoma.
And then I went to Texas A&M for about 8 years.
Oh, okay.
And then I'm in Marriott, Oklahoma.
Now, to have been in Texas so much, why do you figure that you have got this great dairy clarity and your grandfather's someone to come from?
I'm not really sure. It's just kind of adapting to the way that people are kind of taking the same country chords and things like that and turning them into a little bit more of rockabilly kind of chords, and my dad kind of always listened to like Bob Seger and stuff like that. So we had Merle Haggard and Alan Jackson and Bob Seger were about the only records that I had to listen to growing up. So somewhere in all that, and then getting introduced to what we consider, I guess, the faces of Texas Red Dirt Country right now, getting introduced to that in college, like when I first got there, those have all kind of, I guess, shaped
whatever
I am. Well, there's
been a lot of that thrown your way as far as trying to describe, yeah, that's what everyone tries to do. They would try to put you up on. How would you sum yourself up? Tons of adjectives here. Blues, driven, country, the gospel soul. That would be summing up.
Is that about right? Is that about some of that?
I tried to wax poetic justice on the genre there.
Well, all right. So that's all. I was like, man, we've got to. First of all, you're going to do some picking for us in a bit, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, but I do want to spin your track. It's called Burn. Now, we're usually pretty proactive about getting liners from artists and that sort of thing. But Super Dave, if I arrived at midnight, Super Dave, he went kind of above and beyond and over our heads, and he just got a hold of you or somebody, and I was looking, he actually has a Scott Shelby line for his show.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Right here.
That's awesome.
I haven't played it. Do you want to listen to it real quick?
Let's see what it sounds like.
Okay. Do you know how you remember doing this?
I think I had a page of liners one time, but yeah, I remember seeing several of them.
I don't sound like that, do I? No, we always sound different to ourselves because the vibration of that thing changes. That's why we see some on video. You go, oh. Speaking of, you make more YouTube videos for like your on-air interviews and some of your gigs.
Yes, sir, I've been doing that. I guess basically, if you're not going to do it, no one else is usually going to do it for you. But I've been putting those up there, and maybe someday, you know, people will become really interested in that stuff and it'll be a neat catalog.
Well, it's cool to see behind the scenes.
Definitely.
And to see, you know, the other side of things. I mean, right now, it's just a voice. That's all they got. They just got the sound. So it's kind of nice to, in certain my cases, to kind of ruin the illusion. You know, a little bit ruins the magic of radio.
They might be disappointed when they see me too, I'm not sure.
So let's just let them hear you. You want to spin this track?
Definitely.
Okay, now is this off of the older album, something new?
This is off of an album that I cut in Nashville in 2012 called Young and Invincible was the name of the album. This was track 3 on Young and Invincible, but whenever we, Lonnie LaBelle and Derek George were co-writers on this song, and it was kind of one that we knew that had a chance for maybe us to push it towards radio someday, but just finding the right promoters and getting enough financial support to do some of the things as far as getting those songs out there and advertising a little better was kind of what took between 2012 and where we sit today with Burn getting released as a single, I think, 5 weeks ago.
It feels like a hurry and wait situation sometimes, doesn't it?
Definitely, definitely.
Right, let's talk more about that right after we spin this. Here's Scott and Shelby. It's Burn. Listen to the river.
I struck the match, put the flame to what's left of our love.
One of my friends, she's a model. But she got tired of that, and she decided to start a business, and that was her idea. And they launched that in February out of Miami. She used to live in Dallas. She lives in Miami now.
And is it working well for her?
She has it in the Walgreens and CVS there.
That is so cool. I mean, like,
and they're selling for $5.99 for me.
We have that Scott Shelby live in studio right there. It's a Burn. Of course, put it together back in 2012, you say, and it is, it's a hurry up and wait situation, isn't it, to finally get it out and get it on the air. How long have you been pushing this as a single on the radio show?
This is the 5th week, I believe, that it's been released to radio. And this will be the 3rd week that I've went out and tried to kind of do a little radio tour and kind of promote it. Just a little bit harder, but I think this is the 5th week.
You don't have a road buddy to drive around with?
I have people that are in my band, and they have day jobs for some reason.
That makes no sense.
But you're gonna go out there and drive all those miles and play a couple of songs and do an interview, and there's no money in it, and then they flake out real quick.
That's just how it works.
And it's like, hey, I get to go, you know, meet people in the music industry and the radio business.
It definitely works out to get you spun. And it's just a matter of, it's just kind of part of the truth of it. It's the nature of the beast is that we receive music upon disc after disc after disc, just stacks of them. It takes forever to go through piece by piece. And RMD, he has to dedicate a day a week just to that sometimes, you know. And he gets behind. But whenever you have an artist come in and you chat with them, you know, puts it in the DJ's mind, puts it in the music director's mind, and it definitely helps get your spins. It does. It's not, and I hate to say it, being who you know and stuff. Well, you kind of got to get out and know people in the industry. So, yes, radio tours, I highly recommend them to anyone out there that's ready to kick off your career and that sort of thing. And plus, like you said, it's fun to kind of go in. You know, may not have to jump off on stage and sweat bullets. You can just sit with your headphones on and keep your guitar.
It's been one of the more rewarding things that I've done and had the opportunity to do this far. Just getting out and going and talking to the people, DJs, and then whoever might be running to the studio that day, and just getting to talk about music and keep up with the scene. It's just really rewarding.
Now, speaking of that, you have to go around solo, that sort of stuff, and that's part of it. But whenever you're with your band, and you have 4 pieces, is that great follow-up gallery?
I used to have a 5-piece band, now I'm in a 3-piece band, and we have an alternating 4-piece, but that's what I was thinking, but we just haven't found the we're kind of still looking for all the pieces that we want to do for our live show, and it basically just depends upon what musicians are available whenever we're in the area. I guess you got to travel quite a bit to get shows these days if you want to kind of make a living doing it like I've been trying to do. So a lot of times, you know, you might not have five guys that can travel all over the country or all over the state even playing for you, unless, you know, it's like a salary type situation for them. But
definitely, it's tough. I mean, I've been working and stuff here. Sometimes they come in and they're greasy. They probably haven't had a shower in 2 days, you know. And it's, I mean, seriously, it's a horror. It's a trip. And they're like, just been on the road, you know. It's like, you can tell they're just tired from the night before, or whatever. But it's just, it's really cool. The characters. I mean, I know that's a work of passion. I can tell you that'd be passionate about this. Now, this has been something that's been going on for your life as far as music. You grew up around, of course, singing gospel and the church, playing with grandpa, and your mother even playing?
My mother, she played piano and she was a singer.
So you played piano as well?
Yes.
So do you do that on live sometimes, pick some keys instead of putting down the guitar and do some keys?
I've been trying to integrate it in more, especially with some of the live, some of the band situations, but most of the time, I'm more of a gospel piano player, so whenever I'm playing at bars or something solo acoustic, it's just kind of one of those situations where it has to be the right ground for you to sit down and break out a piano set. So I have been dabbling with it, and I play, if I'm playing at a coffee shop or something like that, I definitely play it, but I am in the band, three-piece, and I do alternate bass chord guitar and keys, so that's fun.
That's pretty cool. So. But speaking of acoustic sets and stuff, we've got for. Is this something that you're working on to go to be recorded, or is this already recorded? What do we have?
We're in Texas. I'm going to say something about Texas. So, gotta get tuned up real quick. But which one? Which song about Texas? I do what I wrote about San Angelo. This would be one that I'm planning on recording eventually. I would hope. I've got about 15 songs together for a second album, but just it's finding the funding for that album now, or deciding to do it myself.
Okay.
But both of it took time. This song's called.
You got a little spark on your face. It must be a good story on this one.
This song's a quote. The hook's a quote from one of my old bosses that I worked for back in the day, so it always makes me happy.
Scott Shelby here, happy to sing this song.
It's called Sons of San Angelo. Gotta take these headphones off.
Alright.
You're a power four deep in the little back seat of a low four-door duty truck. Got girls on her right arm, beards in her left hand, hoping we don't lose our luck. We're gonna hit the caliche, drive through the moonlight, get lost on the outskirts of town. With guys like us, they kinda need bars and bright lights, they probably won't stick around. So we're all raised on a few acres, where families made their names. Some Navy St. Plots of land will probably bear our graves. We're from dawn to dusk. You can bet your trust we're in our keep in the saddler fields. But from dusk till dawn, we turn that red dirt on, race some hill up and down the turn roads. And we can hoot with the owls, so with the eagles, we're the sons of San Angelo. Our fears, we'll have to pay for our sins. Cute little blondes and tank tops flicking cigarettes on the white rock. Mama's little boys are becoming men. But we're all raised on a few acres, where families made their names. Some 80 cent plots of land will probably bear our graves. From dawn to dusk, you can bet your trust we're in our keep in the saddler fields. But from dusk till dawn, we turn
Turn that red dirt on and race some hell up and down the turn rows. Yeah, we can hoot with the owls. So with the eagles, we're the sons of San Angelo. We can hoot with the owls. So with the eagles, we're the sons of San Angelo.
Scott Shelby right there. Oh, that's like a coming of age song right there.
I think it was. I think it was a little bit of a coming of age song.
That's what I needed just last week, my friend. Yeah. But then you're still tuning that?
I was a little flat.
Oh.
But maybe y'all couldn't hear it, but I could hear it.
Oh, well, yeah. That's what you said. Headphones off. I'm suffocating there.
Suffocating.
But no.
We're good now.
Fantastic, man. Fantastic. Well, you gotta start throwing your guitars to the back.
Yeah. I know.
You
don't
have a case, I noticed.
Yeah. This is my, it doesn't have a pickup in it, so this is the guitar that I like playing on.
Yeah.
On radio shows.
So now, do you do a lot of just acoustic sets on your own? Just sometimes just put yourself at a little wall somewhere and just like to sit down and just do some light picking? Because I was reading that you do some pretty, like you said, pin drop type music. It gets a little steel in there sometimes. Good balance or something.
Definitely acoustic is the way that I prefer, I guess, to play most of the time. Now, I love getting with a band and having a good time rocking out, but the way that songs come to me is just with a guitar or just with the piano, and that's the way that I like to play those songs because that's the way they came to me. But I definitely, I've dabbled in story songs and just coming of age songs and party songs and just whatever period I was in. But my true, I guess, passion or whatever it is, the love songs, the ballads are always the ones that are, or the really heartfelt songs are the ones that people always really compliment me on. The other ones they say, well, that's good, but we really like the ballads.
But the ladies like the ballads. Right?
Oh, definitely the ladies like the
ballads. Yeah, I was kind of like that big coming of age, the blonde and tank tops. That's fantastic. Now, this side, I've never had to ask this question before, but I was reading, are you bilingual? Can you speak Spanish?
I speak plenty of Spanish, yes.
Really?
Spanish. What would you like to do?
Mexican. Yeah, Mexican. Mexican, yeah, that's what my buddy called himself. So did you sing?
I have several, I guess, covers. I don't have the original stuff in Spanish.
You're not going to break out La Bamba, right?
No, I do like, Rick Rio did kind of a bilingual album that had a lot of his famous Grammy songs, and he went back and did remakes of them in Spanish, and those are a lot of the ones that I know, honestly, and some older Freddie Fender stuff, but I do break down some of the Spanish ballads. If the crowd's right, you know, most people, they're just like, what is he saying? I think that he needs to adjust his setting. Exactly.
His guitar's out of tune again. No, that's great, man. That's really cool. That's the first time I think we've had a bilingual artist come through here that will actually sing some good Spanish tunes. Yeah. I didn't know. Yeah, that was just kind of something that stuck out for me. But before we wrap this up, there's a couple things. Your process of writing, you were quoted saying that all sorts of guitar and all that. You find that a lot of your writing is kind of you off by yourself doing a lot of the writing, if you have a collaborative effort with some people?
It's, right now it's definitely a lot of me by myself, but there's been periods whenever I did do a lot of collaboration with other people, just bouncing ideas back and forth. I grew up with Dusty Perkins. In Bells.
I was just wearing his shirt about 2 days ago.
We grew up about less than a mile away from each other, and we were always kind of, whenever we got our driver's license and things like that, we were always hanging out playing music and writing music. And it was just kind of a really collaborative time then. You know, we were teaching each other how to play and how to write and how to sing and all those things.
That's cool.
But then it kind of, you know, went off and kind of the more heartfelt songs, some of the stuff I needed to get off my chest and things like that. Is really just something that you do kind of on your own time, and then maybe let other people review it, and if they have anything that sticks out, then they might accidentally kind of cover on here with that song.
Well, it's interesting. Kind of birds of a feather flock together. Here's the irony: is that in this case, you're buddies with Dustin Perkins and everything. He went on a solo tour by himself and filmed himself, he said. I mean, I even called him up before he left, and you have this little tripod, that little balls that snap together.
Yes.
Oh, I told him, I was like, you need to go pick one of those up. He's like, that's a good idea. I think I know where one's at. He might have been talking about yours.
Yeah, Perkins went on the back of his tour. Obviously, just got back a couple, 2 or 3 weeks ago.
I got a car, but I don't know how it went. Did he tell you about that?
He had, we talked, once or twice a week these days. But yeah, I think he had a good time. He got to see a lot of country, that's for sure. But he got to record in L.A. He got to record one of his songs.
And he said he left with $100 in his pocket. Did you have the equipment to do that?
Well, I left for my summer. I did a summer tour. He did this kind of fall tour. I left on the first day of May from Oklahoma, and I had a tank of gas, and I had $8 in my pocket.
Whoa.
But I was headed to a $500 gig, luckily. So that was kind of my helpful tour. But then after that, I stayed on the road for 7 straight days, and was going from couch to couch.
By yourself?
It was by myself for a majority of the time. I had a guy that was traveling and he was also a songwriter, a younger guy that was kind of starting out, and he was opening from me. And
there are YouTube videos of that?
There are several YouTube videos. My YouTube channel is S-C-S-H-E-L. Or if you put in Scott Shelby Music on there.
Oh, it'll pop up too. Yeah, that's what I'm putting.
So just my actual channel is S-C-S-H-E-L. I can't get it to change. I would put something more commercial.
S-C-S-H-E-L?
Yeah, like Scott Shelby.
Okay. Yeah. Check that out. So we have Scott Shelby in studio. Where are you headed now? Where are you
going to
head back home and do some
more
work?
I've got to go to everything I own. Yeah, why would you want me, honey?
When
you
knew you'd
gonna
be
KFYN
104.3. You go. I keep pushing this truck a little faster, a little
closer to the ground. Here,
bring
them
out just out on it all.
We just gotta get some songs together. While we have
hey, baby, damn, this old road. That's fantastic, man. Thanks for coming. Lord, I'm gonna steal my soul. Shelby in studio. Call her and I get so tired chasing money. The man just won't leave me all at home. Scott Shelby, thank you so much, buddy. Blues driven country music.
It's gonna steal my soul.
Man, as long as you don't have it.
I get so tired of chasing money.
The man just won't leave me all at home. Yeah, baby, damn, this old road. Go straight to gospel for me, so it doesn't matter what song it is, but there's a lot of ballads that work that way, so I definitely enjoy it.
That's very cool, man. Anytime you have a booking out here in this area, man, you're more than welcome to it, all right?
Awesome.
Give us a call. You cut my teeth on a wedding ring. Perfect. All right, Scott Shelby in studio, thank you very much. Let's get back to some music now.
And I'm not proud of my address. In a torn up town, no postcode envy. But every song's like gold teeth, gray goose dripping in the bathroom, bloodstains, ball gowns, trash in the hotel room. We don't care. We're driving Cadillacs in our dreams. But everybody's like crystal Maybach, diamonds on your timepiece, jet planes, islands, tigers on a gold leash. We don't care. We aren't caught up in your love affair. And we'll never be royal.
Royal.
Crave a different kind of